How's it going, guys? I'm back with another video as quickly as I usually do it, but I figured I'd do a little bit of story time. You know, this about happened about 2 days ago. What happened 2 days ago, I was looking on YouTube just like a normal day, and I'm spending my vacation with my girlfriend right now. And so I'm looking on YouTube, I'm looking at one of my friend's videos, and you know, just checking out, and she made some good points. You know, she was talking about how a lot of females are pretty much trying to be like celebrities, you know, trying to get surgery, being on there, and some females actually killing themselves doing that. Some of them are trying to be like something that they're really not, instead of just being themselves and still being cool with who they are. So, you know, I commented on it. I said, I like your point on the view that that females, you know, try to kill themselves, try to be like something that they're not, just to try to fit in. And, you know, being yourself is going to get you some friends. So I just commented on that. But then that one simple moment, you know, this guy comments on my reply I said in the video, and he says to me, no offense, but you sound so stupid right now. And I'm looking at, you know, I was a little upset at first, I can admit that, and I was just like, okay, let me see what he got going on. So, you know, I saw that, and he was just like, how am I stupid? You know, I put it on there, like, how am I stupid? You know, I'm just pointing out a view that women are killing themselves, like some women are killing themselves trying to look good, trying to do surgeries, and all that other stuff, and it just doesn't make any sense. So, you know, the guy tells me, he said, all these girls are thirsty, all these girls ain't no good, or anything like that, you know, all of them need to die. And then he says, you know, they ate the apple tree, so it's their fault that we in this predicament in the first place. And it was just crazy to me how he was talking. And he just said, you know, it's all women's fault. And he said something that really got to me. He says, I don't read the Bible, and I don't go to church. So I'm just telling you what I know. Now, that's where his problem was, though. You need to learn to respect women. Learn to treat them like you want to be treated, because they came from a part of us. In the book of Hosea, it says that he married a prostitute and had kids with him. To show people, you know, that you can still love a person no matter how down and out they are. That prostitute made her life better for God, and she continues to move forward in that story. So, you know, you gotta treat women with respect. You know, you can't keep calling them hoes and all that other stuff. No matter how bad they are, their story tells it all. That means you still show love for them, you still love them, and you continue to show respect for them. You know, respecting women, because they are part of us. They're gonna be with us till the day we die. So that was my input on that. So my thing with him was, I feel like he should just read his word more in order to understand, because I feel like that's just something that he really heard. So, you know, he needs to take that journey on his own and learn to not disrespect all women. Yes, some women do play you and all the other stuff like that, but at the same time, you shouldn't hate women. You shouldn't disrespect women, because like I said, they're a part of us. And I don't disrespect women. I show women all the love that I do. You know, I show love because God loves them too. God loves all of us. So next time, that's my message pretty much for all of y'all. Next time y'all want to judge somebody and tell them that they're no good, why don't you do your research first and show love for one another instead of saying all these people will die. I don't know what experience that guy had, but don't let your past define on hating everybody, because there's so much hate in the world going on now. So let that love be for one another, you know. And pretty much that's my story for the day. And Josh Peterson.